Hey, welcome back to my channel and thank you for watching. Today I'm going to test out my new welder, MIG 130 by Arccaptain. And in my last video, I did the unboxing and I looked at all the stuff that's in there. Today I'm going to use it for an actual project that I actually started with the yellow one, which is MIG 130 as well. That is one of those unbranded ones that I bought probably 4 or 5 years ago. And it was AC welder that I converted to DC. So if you watch my previous videos, you're gonna see how I converted it from AC to a DC MIG welder. Watch the video and I'll give you my opinion at the end of the video. So I'm gonna test out the Arccaptain welder. I had this project that I started yesterday with my old welder before this one came in Amazon delivery. So this is what I did using the Flux core MIG welder 130 that I converted from AC to DC, and this is what it looks like. It's been working good, but it's not very smooth, and the wire feed still bothers me because you can't really line it up properly with the appropriate power, I guess, the switch, the 1, 2, 3, 4. And then also this one has choice of amps from 40 to 130, so we'll see if that makes any difference. And in terms of the weld quality, this is not perfect welds by any means. It's just basic stuff. Not a professional welder, so don't take my welding skills into effect. This is the weld that came from the 130 welder. Those are before it was grounded, which in my opinion seems to be sufficient to do basic stuff, but we'll see what the other welder would do. I gotta finish that part of the rail, and we'll see how it looks like. So according to this, 1.5 millimeters will take 65 to 75. And then there. So we'll see. This is impressive. First, it only works when you trigger, when you pull the trigger. So if you touch the workpiece, it doesn't do anything until you push the trigger, which is something I'm not used to in the other machine. The other machine is always hot, which makes it dangerous if you accidentally touch the workpiece with your torch. But now I just stacked, and the tanks look really nice and clean, very smooth. Pretty hot in my opinion. I'm gonna lower it a little bit. I'm gonna put it on 60. I'll put it on 70. Put it on 70.
looks totally different than what I'm used to. The other one is so much colder compared to this. You look at this well versus this well. Put it on 65.
So fast forward 2 hours, completed the project. The left side, the long part of the rail is done by the yellow welder, and the short part is done by the Arccaptain. And I can tell you, I'm very impressed with the Arccaptain performance.
Well, here's my conclusion on the Arccaptain MIG 130. Compared to the yellow one behind it, it's half of the weight. It's almost 15 pounds with the wire in it, versus almost 30 pounds on the yellow one. It's a transformer type welder versus the Arccaptain is actually one of those inverter type welders. So it's a different technology that doesn't use that heavy transformer inside of it. So that takes away a lot of the weight. So that's difference number one. The next difference is the Arccaptain torch doesn't get activated until you pull the trigger. The yellow one it was hot all the time. So even if you put it on the workpiece or something like that and end up touching the ground, it always starts to spark. So that's a good feature on the Arccaptain. Is it only gets activated with the relay when you pull the trigger on the torch. So that's difference number one. Number two is it gives a lot of heat. Based on the settings for the project I was using, the recommendation was to use 70 amps, and I actually had to turn it down because it was giving so much heat. After this project, I used it for a couple of other projects, and I always had to turn it down because even if I use recommended settings, it still gives a lot of heat. Especially if I'm using sheet metal, I have to be careful not to burn through because the amount of power that it gives, which is a great thing. But if you're welding sheet metal and things like that, you're gonna have to watch it so you don't burn through the material. One trick that I've learned by using it on a couple of projects, if to avoid burning through, is actually I trick the machine. So I'm running 0.03 wire, but I actually change the setting to 0.04, and I run it on the lowest amperage, and it actually gives me a cooler weld that way. So I actually trick the machine to give me a lesser amperage by changing the settings from 0.03 into 0.04 wire. So that's one thing that I've noticed. So far I've been happy with it. It's very portable, only 15 pounds. You can toss it in the car and or the truck and go do quick jobs, things like that. So I tripped the breaker a couple of times when I maxed out the amps over 100 amps on 120 volt. I tripped the 20 amp breaker. So if you're gonna be welding thick materials and you're gonna need high amps, you might wanna use a 30 amp breaker. Otherwise you're going to be tripping the breaker every few minutes. From a simplicity of a machine, that it couldn't get simpler than that. You don't have to mess with the wire settings or the wire feed. And I've never had any issues with the wire feed with this machine. I've had a lot of issues with the yellow one. Either it's too fast or too slow, and it was not really consistent weld all the times. For the Arccaptain, they use the synergy settings, so it automatically sits it based on the amperage, and it's actually working really well. I've never had any issues with it so far. One of the things that I've noticed is the limitations on the machine. If you try to weld aluminum, you cannot weld it on this machine because it's not an AC, so it's a DC only machine. So you're limited to only steel or stainless steel. Even if you get a TIG, the TIG torch that doesn't come with it, you cannot use aluminum. So you need an AC-DC machine that's capable of welding aluminum. So my the only thing that I'm thinking that's going to be a limitation if I try to up my game and I try to weld aluminum is the problem with not having the AC option in there. The other limitation that I see, and it's not a problem with the machine, it's a problem that I picked the lowest option machine. If you try to use the gas for example, for stainless steel, you cannot use this machine. You're going to have to buy the next level up. So if you're planning on using gas in the future for stainless steel or something like that, you're going to have to use the next one up. There are some stainless steel flux core that's available. I actually ordered some, but I have not really used it so far. On this machine, I'm gonna use it and see how it works before I comment on that. So far, it's a good machine. It's very lightweight, very portable, does everything you need it for light fabrication or light repairs. I have not used the stick option yet. I may use it. I actually find that the flux core is the easiest welding that you can ever learn. So I'm sticking with the flux core for now. I have welded with stick welding before. It takes practice, more practice, and especially depending on what electrodes you use. So in my opinion, Flux Core would be the easiest thing that you can start with. So that's my 2 cents for this machine. Overall, it's a great buy. I bought it for $109. I'm going to leave a link in the description if you'd like to buy it. Currently, it's on sale. You can either buy it from Amazon or you can buy it from their website directly. Thank you for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.